So there's a brand new way to create videos inside of ChatGPT. This is done by utilizing an action inside of the brand new GPT's feature. And before you conclude that you won't be able to do this because you might not have ChatGPT Plus, don't worry. I'll show you another way how you too can create videos inside of ChatGPT. Now look, these obviously aren't Hollywood movies, but I found two business use cases that I will start using from here on out because it's so simple to implement. The first one is creating video versions of meeting summaries. And the second use case will be turning another PDF, which is a guide, into a video presentation. This will effectively show you how to turn any type of written guide into a video guide in a simple manner. And the tool that we'll be using is the brand new GPT by InVideo AI. And at this point, I should point out, yes, this video is actually sponsored by InVideo. But I told them, I'll be giving you my honest take, and this is a video I would like to create anyway. Because, come on, let's be real. Scripting, editing, creating a voiceover.
Welcome to our video guide on mastering company events.
And doing the subtitles all inside of one prompt in ChatGPT is unique enough of a use case for it to be worth a separate video. So let's dive right into it and show you how to use this GPT to create videos inside of ChatGPT. Everything that I'm showing you today is using a free account and you will be able to do the same, but it does include a watermark and there's also a 10-minute limit per account, which should be plenty for the short 1 to 2 minute videos that we'll be creating today. So first things first, you can head on over to invideo.io/videoai and this will link you to their GPT inside of the GPT store. Now, yes, for this, you do need a ChatGPT Plus account as of today, but you can get around that by going directly to their website. But in this video, we'll be using the workflow where we actually use ChatGPT to create the video. Alternatively, you can head on over to the GPT store and just search for InVideo. There you go. Okay, so let's hop right into the use cases. So, and what I'll be using as an example is a standard operating procedure that I created for the AI Advantage, and we use this to prepare for live events. No need to go into the details here. There's 3 steps. One is event pre-planning. The second one is hosting. And then we have a post-event follow-up. But basically, you can do this with any PDF. It might be educational. It might be a standard operating procedure, or it could be something completely different. But my point is this workflow is universal because what I'm going to do here is I'm just going to export this as a PDF. And then all I'm going to do is copy paste this prompt that I provided in the description below to you. And then I'm just going to go ahead and attach the PDF. And that is literally it. Now, yes, you could go in and customize the prompt. I'll give you a quick summary. First, I just tell it to create a video based on an SOP. Then I remind it to follow the structure very carefully and that it should include every single part of the document. Then I just give it general information like a title, more context, what the voiceover should sound like, what the tone of the text should sound like, what kind of background music I want, where the video will be going, and what the audience and length is. Now, you don't have to do any of this, right? You could just upload this and say, create a video based on this document, and it will do a decent job.
Easy peasy lemon squeezy.
But I just like to control all variables, and in this use case, I would be running multiple PDFs from it, right? So by making the prompt this detailed, you can just eliminate a lot of variants and make them super consistent. So yeah, I guess a simplified version of it would look something like this, but for trial and error, I added all these different building blocks. So that's literally it. I'll just run this application, and it will already get to work. And as you'll see, right away, it will start using the action that they built into the background. So this is one of the use cases where actions make a lot of sense because they created a product that generates videos from thin air. So there you go. All I need to do is confirm this action. And that is literally that created the video and I can click this link. And look, I don't have an account here or anything. To generate this, you need to log in one time. So what I'm just going to do is I'm going to say join with Google. I'm going to pick one of my Google accounts, say continue. And there you go. After about 2 minutes, I have a finalized video. Let's have a look.
Welcome to our video guide on mastering company events, a guide to SOP. This instructional video is designed for non-technical team members and will walk you through our standard operating procedures for hosting high-quality events. Let's get started. Firstly, we'll cover the tools and terminology used in our event planning. These include Circle, our live streaming platform, and Typeform for feedback collection.
So that's not bad, right?
It's not too bad.
It created the video, it generated the voice, it put music in the background. I could even prompt it to include subtitles, but I would like to make some changes, right? Most of the time, there's going to be some custom elements that I might want to add, or maybe I want to make the intro shorter. So one thing that stood out to me here is that I would want to include some custom visuals, right? At this point where it's talking about the community platform, it doesn't have screenshots of that and it includes some random logo. So I would want to change that, right? Now I could do that via text, but I found it to be even more precise if you hit this little edit button. Again, you don't need to know video editing to use this at all. That's the cool part about this. It's really beginner friendly. So for example, this image, I would want to change out for an image like this where it actually shows the platform that I'm talking about, right? So let's just say this is that image. Then I say upload media. And just by clicking it, it will get replaced. And if I apply changes, we're good to go.
Firstly, we'll cover the tools and terminology used in our event planning.
Beautiful. So you can see how quickly we could get to a result that is way better than just a PDF, especially for visual learners like me. Now in a second, I'll show you a second use case along with some ChatGPT tricks. But before that, I have a few tricks that we can do right inside of this interface. One would be adding subtitles. So if I just say add subtitles to the video, it's going to redo it and generate subtitles for me.
Welcome to our video guide on mastering company events. This instructional video is designed for non-technical team members.
Or also the music is a bit quiet, right? So I could just say increase the volume of the background music. And it did it. So you could do the same thing with the voiceover. You could change some of the shots that it's using here for different ones. Or you could even edit the video just by using natural language. Now it might not always be perfect, but you can always go one step back. Okay, so for a second use case, we'll be turning a PDF guide into a video. Now you could also do this with instructional videos. So I have some instructional videos over here. And what I could do is I could use OpenAI's Playground. So if you go to this link and then you set this to complete, there's a button in the top right here. And here you can upload text files or video files. And OpenAI's Whisper is going to transcribe the video file for you. So you can work with it inside of ChatGPT, which will allow you to work with it within video. And that workflow allows you to turn long videos into short videos. So just drag this in. This would create a transcript. I would attach it inside of ChatGPT and prompt on top of that. In this case, we're going to do that based off a PDF, but now you're aware of this workflow too. So this right here is a little Midjourney guide that Dominique in our community created. It's various use cases of how to put a green screen inside of a device. I'm just going to upload it and include a little prompt. All right, so here I use a super simple prompt. This is one of my favorite structures. It's super basic yet very powerful. So first I have the results-oriented instructions. I want you to create a summary video that is a visual presentation of a tutorial PDF that I attached. This just tells ChatGPT exactly what's going on. Then I have two steps. First, summarize it into 10 bullet points. Second, create a short video based on the summary. So now it understands that it first needs to summarize the PDF before it creates the video. Then I like to include some additional instructions in this format, keep the intro extremely short, refer to the fact that Midjourney is a paid application, and here you can include any other context that might be relevant to what you're working on. Then I define the audiences, non-technical team members who never used AI art, and a length of 1 to 2 minutes. And of course, I attach the guide. Let's do it. So there you go, it analyzed it, create a 10 bullet point summary. Let's have a brief look over this because the video is going to be based on this. If this isn't correct, the video will be no good. Yep, this is really good. There's the formula and it shows some of the use cases. This is perfect. So off it goes, it created the video. I can click the link. All right, took about 2 minutes. Let's see what we got.
Imagine a world where you are the master of digital imaging. Welcome to the world of Midjourney V6. A world revolutionized by its innovative green screen technology.
Okay, that's a good beginning. I actually really like the fact that it uses all this green screen B-roll to illustrate what we're going for, but we're certainly missing some concrete visuals of what we're representing. So I'm gonna take some quick and dirty screenshots here, and then I'll let the software figure out what to do with them. And simply by going here to edit, so for example, this starter image could be one of the screenshots like so. I'll also upload the other two, replace this, and then this Photoshop image is gonna turn into this. But what if the messaging is not exactly right? So for example, in this case, I don't like the opening statement. The core works, but I want to change more than just the media. Well, up here, you can go to the edit script tab. So I'll make a few changes here. Obviously, this is not green screen technology, but AI technology. Change the titles around. And there you go. That's pretty good. So we changed the script, added a few visuals, and it adjusted it in about 30 seconds.
Imagine a world where you are the master of digital imaging, where you can create photorealistic mock-ups with just a few clicks. Welcome to the world of Midjourney V6, a world revolutionized by innovative AI technology. Midjourney V6, a tool designed for professionals from various fields.
Amazing. Honestly, this makes a great little guide, which you can just export like so. And to just skip the steps of writing a script, generating the voiceover, picking out music, picking out stock footage, editing it all together. It all just happens relatively automatically. And then you can tweak it afterwards. And that is essentially it. I've been creating videos for most of my life, and this is legitimately the easiest workflow I have seen yet. All right, so you can go ahead and play around with this for free. If you want to get more serious about it, you can get the paid plan. And over here, you can find a guide on the various AI video generators, which you can absolutely combine with the AI video editing that you've seen here. And one more thing, don't forget to have fun while you're doing it. I'll see you around.